Morning, everybody. I'm Benji Stute with Palm Beach County's Environmental Resources Management. Today, we are out in the middle of Loxahatchee Slough Natural Area. This is our largest natural area at almost 13,000 acres, and it is really the heartbeat of the wild and scenic Loxahatchee River. This is one of these public lands where the river gets its water, and today, we're out here with site managers Dave and Melissa, as well as wading bird expert Mark Cook from South Florida Water Management District. And we're going to check on a wading bird rookery that is in the middle of a swamp. We're gonna get a lot deeper than this today. But hope y'all join us, come learn about wading birds and why it's so important to protect these areas. Let's go swamping. So we're out here in the middle of the swamp, the place that, you know, we love the most. I'm here with Dave Whitmer and Melissa, who are the site managers of Loxahatchee Slough Natural Area. So we're out here today trying to find wading birds, and these are the smaller wading birds, little blue herons, snowy egrets, tri-colored herons. So Dave, how long have you guys been keeping an eye on this rookery here?
So we've been monitoring this rookery for 5 years now. This is our fifth year coming out, and depending on the water level, sometimes they move around. But, you know, we're zooming in on where they are for this year, and, you know, we're going to go out and check out, see the nesting effort, and kind of use that as an indicator for our restoration work that we've done.
Great. So today the goal is to try to count as many nests as we can.
Exactly.
Okay. And Melissa, this isn't the only species you all are monitoring out here that's listed or rare. What other bird species are you guys looking at here?
We also monitor the swallowtail kite, and that's something we were fortunate to develop a relationship with the Avian Research Conservation Institute. So they gave us some techniques to monitor their roosting activity as well as their nesting activity. And then we've also started monitoring snail kites with Avian Research. And that's been a great relationship, and we've been fortunate that they've been able to tag both swallowtail kites and snail kites with GPS telemetry so that we can learn more about their movements and the areas that they use within the Loxahatchee Slough and the adjacent natural areas.
Right, so such an awesome partnership with Avian Research Conservation Institute as well as the Palm Beach Zoo. And so if you guys follow our social media, we actually tell stories from ARCI about where our birds are going when they migrate out of Loxahatchee Slough during the winter. So let's go check out this roost and or rookery and see what we can find, huh?
All right.
Well, for this part of the rookery, which is the larger portion,
so
we ended up with 83
really
little blue herons, 19 tricolor herons, and 7
really
cattle egrets. Here's an example of the little blue heron eggs, and they're blue.
All right, so we are in the middle of this gorgeous pond apple swamp, this wading bird rookery here. I've got Mark Cook with me. So he's an avian ecologist with South Florida Water Management District. You guys have seen him before. And he's out here helping us study these birds because, Mark, you write the Everglades wading bird report every year.
The South Florida wading bird report, So we cover wading bird colonies all across South Florida, and count them up and see how these birds are doing.
So Dave and Melissa have just finished a nest count in this rookery here, and we're kind of delighted to find out that we have over 100 nests in this colony. We have over 80 nests of little blue herons. So Mark, tell us why this is significant for this area.
These Palm Beach County natural areas are particularly important because they provide a landscape scale area for these birds to forage in. So one small area, even the size of the Everglades, isn't enough to be able to support these birds at any one time. So what we need is a sort of landscape of different habitats, different water depths, different types of habitats for these birds to feed in. And these areas here are just phenomenal for creating that habitat before these birds nest. So, you know, we have tens of thousands of birds nesting in the Everglades and Lake Okeechobee, but a lot of those birds are first here. in these Palm Beach County natural areas, feeding in these wetlands to get up to their breeding status, you know, enough food to get them into breeding status so they can breed elsewhere.
Right, and now this colony here that we're visiting, this is a genus of wading birds called Egretta. So these are our smaller herons and egrets, the snowy egret, the little blue heron, the tricolored heron.
Right.
They generally nest in these colonies that are kind of separate from the other wading birds, but it's really special that we have these birds nesting because they're really struggling in the Everglades in South Florida, right?
That's right. So these birds have declined. The Everglades would have at least 10,000 nests of these birds on an annual basis. Nowadays, we're getting probably 200 to 500 at the most.
Two to 500 in the Everglades.
Right, so we've seen a dramatic decline, and not just in the Everglades, elsewhere as well. And so this is particularly special to have this here because it's providing, you know, great nesting habitat as well as foraging habitat for these birds that are struggling. And right now, so a lot of these birds are declining because of water levels and how that affects their food. But right now we're not really sure why these birds are declining. So there's a lot of research going on trying to understand what our food habits are and trying to figure out what it is that's causing this decline. It's just fantastic to be able to see so many nesting here in, you know, in Palm Beach County natural area.
Yes, so we've got one more satellite rookery to check, so we're gonna go do that if we can get out of the swamp here.
Yeah,
so.
I know, right?
Let's make our way over there.
All right.
Yep, I found it. All right, so we made it out of the swamp. What an incredible day. Thank you to Mark, Dave, Melissa for allowing us to join in today as we monitor wading birds on this special place, Loxahatchee Slough Natural Area. Melissa, so how many nests did we document? 158 nests, so almost 160 nests in this one colony right here in Loxahatchee Slough. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys follow along, and we'll see you next time for another story from our natural areas.